Welcome to my channel Education Helpers Academy. Today we are going to discuss
important topic, right? So that is the multiple regression analysis. Dear learners, already we learned the fundamental topics of regression analysis and fundamental topics of correlation analysis. Now in this unit, we would like to introduce the most important topic, that is multiple regression model. So what is the regression analysis? The regression analysis, it states that, right, the average and functional relationship between two variables, right, that is one is the dependent variable and another one is the independent variable, which predict the all the variables, right? In the case of simple linear regression model, we already learned the basic radial regression, simple linear regression model, that is, right, you regress a dependent variable y and independent variable x. What is the simple linear regression model? Simple linear regression model equation is, in the case of population terms, so that is y is equal to alpha plus beta x plus mu in the term, it is denoted to, right, the population parameter. If you are taking into sample population, in the case of simple regression model, the equation is, that is y is equal to alpha plus beta x plus mu. So already we learned, what we have to learn, there is a regression between the two variables. One is the dependent variable and another one is the independent variable, in the case of two variables. But in real life, you have to search and you have to use the research methods to use more than two variables. If you can use the more than two variables, you can regress the what is the dependent variable y and what is the other independent variables are x1, x2, x3, so on. So in the case of two or more than two variables, you can regress the, right, y and other independent variables are x1, x2, x3. We can use this multivariable regression model. So in this model, we have to discuss, right, there are these most important topics, right? What are the topics? There is one, first regression equation. If you are using the multiple variables, that is explanatory variables are more than two, what is the regression equation? And if the estimation of the parameters, what is the parameter you can estimate it in the regression of two different variables or more than two different variables? And after that, you can interpret the regression coefficient. You must have to find the regression coefficient to predict or the average between the explanatory variable and explained variables. And after that, you can find out the goodness of fit. That means R square. That is the coefficient determination is R square. What is the R? Why is useful in the multiple correlation, multiple regression analysis? And after that, analysis of ANOVA. ANOVA is also interrelated to multiple regression analysis. We have to learn step by step, then only whether this multiple regression analysis is applicable in that particular sample more than two variables or not, right? After the process, you can understand the problem of multicollinearity. What is the multicollinearity and what is the problem of a heteroscedasticity and what is the problem of autocorrelation? After that, whether the model is fit in that particular variables or not, you can using this step by step, you can discuss it step by step. These all the right parameters you must have to check when you can use the multiple regression model. So as of now, we already learned we have to study the classical linear regression model is, that is the y is equal to alpha plus beta x. So in other words, you try to explain the change in y in terms of the change in x, or you had hypothesis linear relationship between y and x, that you can call as this y is equal to alpha plus beta x. So here in the simple equation, there is no population parameter, simple linear regression analysis, that is you can say CLRM, LRM, classical linear regression model equation is equal to this in the case of two variables. Then what we'll do, after you can identify the simple regress, that means you can regress the two variables, one is the independent variable, another dependent variable, y and x, right? After that, you went to the estimate two constant. What are the constant? This is the earlier constant, a constant. What is the b? B is the regression line of y and x, or regression line of x and y. So earlier you can say alpha is the constant term. Now what we'll do, if you have to calculate the multiple regression analysis, we have to use, right, to convert it to estimation, or estimate to constant, or alpha and beta. That means you can rewrite it, that equation into, if you can use the, right, estimation of, right, constants alpha and beta. That means, according to, you can rewrite the multiple regression analysis, right, simple linear regression is, y is intercept is equals to, what is the equation, alpha intercept plus beta and x. This is the new equation after you can constant estimation of the constant of alpha and beta, the relationship between the x and y variable, you can equation is this. So in the present unit, we are discussing our extended type of analysis for the MEG in more realistic and the comprehensive manner. So what we'll do, there is just steps how to can estimate the regression equation in multiple variables. So what first step is, we'll generate our generalistic the model non-explanatory variables. First you can write, there are steps to draw the regression, that you can call, right, regression equation. Yes, regression equation. What are the steps? First step is, you can discussing about is, generalize the model non-explanatory variables. First, you can identify the non-explanatory variable. What is the second step? At the next stage, we are interpret the partial regression. Interpret the partial regression. Right? Partial regression. These are the steps to can derive the regression analysis or regression equation from simple linear regression equation to multiple linear regression. What are the steps? First, you can explain the non-explanatory variables. After that, you can interpret the partial regression. And after that, we'll try to examine the large should the number n be. You try to examine the large sample numbers. Try to examine the large sample number, that is n. N is denoted to the number of the sample of the researcher. Right? So all these steps you can describe, we examine the condition whether the assumptions which make this extension of the right generalization possible or not. That means the problem of multi, you can check the, we solve the particularly above these assumptions or the steps, you can understand that whether the multicollinearity or whether the heterosticity. After this step, after that you can say autocorrelation. So after this, you can find out what is the multicollinearity and what is the heterosticity after this step, and what is the autocorrelation. According to that, you can identify that whether your model is fitted in that particular above two variables or not. So first you can discuss in what is the class of estimation at a maximum like after that you can discussing about, right, maximum likelihood. The other OLS model, ordinary least square model of, right, maximum likelihood model. Maximum likelihood model. maximum likelihood estimation. After all the process, after all the process, you have to discuss this maximum likelihood estimation. So that now you can understand. According to that, we can discussing or we can estimate the multiple regression analysis. So what the step? First step is you can step the draw the regression coefficient. That is the non-explanatory variables. After that, interpret the partial regression, and after that, try to examine the large numbers of cells. Just remember these steps, then automatically you can draw the multiple regression equation. So you can look at how after this simple linear regression, y intercept is equal to alpha, beta, so on. So, however, now onwards we will write the model that is slightly different form. What is the form? Plus beta 1 and x. After the interpretation of the estimation of the rate, estimation of the constant values, you can rewrite this equation into y and is equals to b0 plus b1 and alpha. This will help to presentation the same that as when the more explanatory variable. Suppose the more this will help to this equation will help to when you can use the more explanatory variables like x1, x2, so on, xn. Right? We can use this in this equation, it is useful to the parameters. What are the parameters? That the simple indicator, the coefficient with respect to this is the coefficients with respect to right. This coefficient is x1 and another b2 coefficient is x2. That means beta 1 is the coefficient x1, beta 2 is coefficient to x2. This equation will help to the coefficient of right with respect to the beta 1, beta 2 will helpful. So that model consists that present section we explanatory variables x1, x2 and non-stochastic specification. So that we can express the non-stochastic process. What is this non-stochastic process? What is the stochastic process? The stochastic process is, it indicates that the regression between the x to y variable. How it is regressed? How it is the predicted value will estimate to one variable to another variable. So that value should be equivalent to non-stochastic specification. What is the non-stochastic process? There is no regression between the two variables in the case of, you can use this B0, B1 coefficient values. If you are using the coefficient values, what is the equation now? The equation again now is equals to the estimation. This is the E, the estimation of Y with non-stochastic process. With non-stochastic process, the multiple regression analysis is estimation of y is equals to beta 0, right, plus beta 1, x1. x1 is the one explanatory variable, and plus beta 2, x2. This is the another equation. After you can write it the coefficient of b1, b2 non-explanatory variables with the estimation non-stochastic process. The equation is E by is equal to B0. This is the B0, B1, X1, B2, XT. The same model, there is a stochastic form. What is the stochastic? Now you can say there is no residuals or there is no average relationship. There is no regression with the two variables, independent variable and dependent variable. Now you can write it the same model. Right, you can write it the other form, right? The same model, stochastic form, the same model, rewrite the stochastic process. So in the stochastic process, we'll have the error term. What is the error term? This is you can call as error term. What is the error term? Include. In the case of stochastic process means there is a random relationship between x to y. There is the average relationship between x to y will happen with the error term include. What is the error term? In the case of error term include, what is the regression equation? Y is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 plus Right. What is this? Earlier, this is you can call as error term. What is the error term? Already we learned that error term is the population parameter. The population parameter. So this is the equation after stochastic process with including the error term mu. So what is the error term? This entire this see, look at this entire you can call as error term. Now what is the equation of E is equal to the error term of this estimation. E means this is the stochastic process with some estimation sum of the squares is y is plus error term. So this is the equation after stochastic process. You can explain the independent variable to the dependent variable with the right estimated value of the explained and determined variable. Now what we'll do after this process, right? We have to do after this process, we have to do right the regression equation into subscript the right. We can use this subscription. Right, we can use the subscription T with Y0. Yes, right. So here after stochastic process, explained variable to expand variable. Yes, explanatory variable means independent variables, explained variable means dependent variable. After the relationship between X and Y, right, we must have to include error term. Error term what? The entire population parameter, that is mu. The mu is indicated to a population parameter. You can include the relationship between x1, x2. What is the explained variable here? X1 is the one explained variable and x2 is the another explained variable. This is the b0, b1 as the parameters. Estimate the parameter. Estimate the constant parameter. There is no value on that. That value will always is equals to 0. Right. So what about the one independent variable? To how it is independent to the y, and what about the x2 variable independent to, what is the relation between the d y? So this entire this b0 plus b1 x1 and b2 x1, this all you can call as estimated parameter. Already second step, the estimated parameters of the regression equation is equals to right y is equal to e y plus mu. Therefore, EY means this B0 plus B1 X1 plus B2 X2, so on. Clear? In the case of two regression analysis. Now you can Y is equal to, instead of this this all the equation, you can say EY plus mu. This is the new equation after the stochastic process. After interrelation between the variables. Then the equation is in this one. So after what we'll do, you can use the subscript T. You can use the subscript T with, you can use the subscript T with X, Y, sorry, Y0, X1, X2, and mu, right, to denote T, right, observation. So this is available in our reading. Just look at that page number, I think 38 in the third block. Right? So denote the observation. So look at after this, you can the above equation, this the below this equation, so you can say equation one. Right? In this equation, for suppose the equation, this is the equation one, where equation one is EYG, this is the equation one, and this is the equation two. And this is the equation 3. The above equation, this equation you can rewrite into after the substitution of the T, right? So why, what is the subtraction of the T, that means YT is equals to, you can write it, this one is equals to, again, B0, right? Plus B1 X1 T, here we can the subtract we can the subscript subscripts, right, subscript T with Y0, that means you can add it T subscript T into or you can say substitute to the t into y0, x1, x2 and all denoted t-th observation. That means you can substitute y, you can substitute into b1, x2 is equals to t and x2 is t. That means you can add it the substitute of t into in the same equation. What is the same equation? Y is equal to ey plus mu. Ey means this all, b0, b1, b2. You can write it again. So what about yt? Now you can write it the same equation. Yt is equals to, right, if you can use the error term, what is the error term? You can add it the error term, then again the equation into b1 x1t plus b2 x2t plus, even error term also, you can substitute t. And you can write it this equation into, you can write it the equation into yt is equal to eyt, right, plus ut respectively. I think now it is clear. Just I have to show that board. After this equation, right, this is third equation. After this equation, we can the substitute t with y0, x1, x2, and all to denote the t-th observation. Right. Now, yt is equal to this b0, b1, x1, b2, x2, t. Just you can substitute the yt and xt and x2, t. x1, t, x2, t. After that, yt, this what? This is what? This is, you can indicate it to this entire. And u2, you can add in the parameter. That is the parameter, error term has to use. Because error term is already there. Because you can use all the number of the sample parameter. After that, you can identify two variables are, it is depicted the, or it is regressed the dependent variable. So all this et, eyt, eyt, right? b0, b1, so ut is the, this equation is generally you can say, in the relationship above, the component, right? Right? He, in this relationship, right? B0 plus this B0 plus B1 X1 plus B2 X2, right? Each you can call it as systematic or deterministic component. Systematic component or deterministic component. Deterministic component. Right? What is this called? This is what called as systematic component or deterministic component. That means the determinants variables it indicated to, you can dependent variable as to predict, regress the this all determinants component. What are the different determinants component? That is x1, x2 are the determinants component. The component u1 is non-systematic and random component. What about this ut? All are is a systematic components. And what about the mu t? Mu t is the non-systematic random component. Non-systematic random component. That means mu one is the, there is not a random component. Random component means it is regressed to the y variable. It is not impact on the y dependent variable. It is not impact on the dependent variable. Just it is non-random variable. Random means the correlation between the x to y, y to x. X to y. Right? That mu is just a parameter. There is no, right, random variable. Random variable means regressed between the two variables. It's not a regressive value. That's why mu is the non-random variable. So that the component mu non-systematic variable determine the factors of x1, x2. x1, x2, mu1 is the factors. But x1, x2 is the random variable, random component and the systematic components. But mu2 is the non-systematic component. So the model specified by the equation, that is the one first equation is Ey is equal to this entire equation, right? And after that, this equation, you can say that linear regression model, which is linear in parameters. This is you can call as linear regression parameters. So entire the final equation is equal, this is you can call as, right, the linear regression parameter. So after we know the this linear regression parameter, what we'll do? We have to do the estimation the parameter. We know the parameters. What are the parameters? X1, X2 is, these two are the random parameters, but this is mu is the non-random parameter. How you can know? There is an estimation of the parameters. That is, you can call it the, you can use the ordinary least square method. What is the ordinary least square method? That we have to discuss step by step. So look at here. Now you can understand, after this equation, after analysis of this all the process, right, what is the regression equation? The regression equation, the multiple regression analysis is, right, y is equals to beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 and plus error term, plus not so so, plus error term. This is the multiple regression model equation. After the process of all these things, the finally the equation shows that this is the regression equation, the multiple regression. So what is, now we can understand what are the parameters. This parameter x1, x2 is the random parameters, and mu is the non-random parameter or not systematic parameter. How you can say, you can estimate the coefficient, estimate the parameter. How we would like to discuss, that is, estimate the parameters. How you can estimate the parameters? There is a one model, that is the ordinary least square model. Ordinary least square, right? Ordinary least square method or approach. Right? What is this ordinary least square approach? We collect a sample of observation y1, x1 and x2. We have collected the sample through random sampling, simple random sampling or systematic sampling. We have collected the samples, right? One sample is the dependent variable, that is the finding of the problem. Another sample is the explanatory variable, that is the dependent variable. What two you are thinking about here? The two independent variables. We are collected the sample observations, that is y1 and x1 and x2. These are the two variables we have to collected. And after that, write down sample regression function. Right? What is the sample regression after collection of this figure? What is the sample regression equation? Sample regression, I just only focus on the board, right? The sample regression, right, function is equals to what? Y1 is equal to B0 plus B1 X1 plus B2 X2, B1, B2, so on. Just I explained. Note that, I think board is clear. Yes, please. Note that this point B0 and B1, B2, right, have replaced the corresponding population parameter, that is B0, B1, B2. This is the population like this. This is the regression equation. After you can collecting the.
Thank you for watching this video. If you like the video, please share and subscribe the channel.